obesity and the epidemic we have with that in America. I would love to get a little bit of your insights about what it is that has caused this financial health crisis we have in America.
Well, I think most people don't realize, but we know we get stressed from so many things, but money is one of the deepest ones, and I think it's because we feel the least in control of money. And money is an expression of power in our lives, what we can and can't do. And for many people, what's happened to them is when they feel out of control because it's so complex, where do I start, how do I go about it, I don't know what to do, I'm so busy. What happens is we end up starting to feel that stress, and we start to eat, or some people smoke, or some people drink, or it starts to mess with your intimate relationship, and then everything gets messed up. And that all converts, as you know, to physical stress, which converts to emotional and physical stress.
You take the last few years of your life to write a book called
obviously do, your physical body, as you and I both know, your emotions, and then money. And what I found is when 2008 happened, I grew up in a really tough financial environment. I went out to get the car and it's gone, not because of the stolen, because we didn't pay it for it, so we took it. No money for food. So I saw people losing their homes in mass, and I saw people losing half their net worth, and I knew it was based on manipulation. It made me crazy, and I have unique access. I've coached one of the top 10 financial traders in the world.
Tony.
This is so quiet walking over here. I can feel it.
Let me bring you over here so you can see y'all. So go ahead, Teresa, share your story. I'll get Tony to work on it.
Tony, I feel like I am a hamster on a wheel. I live paycheck to paycheck. I have twins who are in their second year of college. My younger one is going to college next year. And I feel trapped. I'm stressed. And I never pictured my life the way it is now.
Are you paying for your twins' college tuition?
Yes, I am.
So easy for someone on the outside to talk about it. Right? Your physical stress, emotional stress, I know is real. But if you really want to change it, then you have to make some new choices. And right now, the story you have, we all are affected by the story we tell ourselves. Some people say, you know, I'm a gator on my road. And I go, okay, put it down and come over here. They look at me like I'm crazy. Yours is, I'm a hamster on a wheel. And how many times do you tell yourself that?
Every day.
And so that's what you feel. See, so whatever we tell ourselves, we experience. So here's the truth. There's a couple options for you. One of those options is you have to understand that you can still be financially free, but somehow, even though it seems impossible, you got to take a small percentage of what you have and pretend the government put a tax on you. You'd hate that tax, you'd swear you won't pay that tax, but they'd still take the money. So I'll give you an example. There's a man named Theodore Johnson. He worked for UPS. He never made more than $14,000 in an entire year in his life. It's the most he ever made. At 70 years old, he's worth $70 million. How is that possible?
I don't know.
How is that possible?
I'll tell you, when they asked Warren Buffett, just not putting it in the places that can get you ahead. So that's why you're the hamster on the wheel. What his friend said is, we're going to take a tax. 20% of your money you're never going to see. And it's going to go in this investment account. And when, over the years, it compounds. And it's amazing what it does. Second thing for you. I know you're not going to like this one. What if your twins had to actually pay for some of that college education themselves? So what I want you to do is I want you to find no less than a minimum of 10% and as much, ideally, as 15%. So if you will make that promise, I will get someone to coach you and get you a car through. Will you make it happen?
You're saying about saving percentage, you know, a piece of your income every time, but it's, you know, that's kind of really hard to reach that goal when you have children or other, you know, limited situations. So how do you handle that?
Well, it starts with changing that belief. It's not true that you don't have children. It's not hard. Right? We all know that's true. The story you have that says I have three children and so it's really hard. Mm-hmm. The more you tell yourself, the more you can't do anything. It's like hypnosis. You're hypnotized into it so hard I can't. It is hard and you can. But we got to start small and get momentum. That's the piece that we got to do for you. And for you right now, what you really need to get someone who's going to come kick your butt a little bit. You need somebody who's going to not take this stuff. Because here's the challenge. When you surround yourself with girlfriends, the beauty of feminine women is they support each other. But the challenge with that is you can support each other and feeling good and then not change. So we need two things. No more story and a new game plan. If you're up for it, I'll get someone who will actually coach you.
Something about the guy part.
Yes,